This blog is for people who want to get a very high level concept and understanding of electric substation. This picture here that we see, this is a picture of a substation. So substations play a very, very key ingredient. And from afar, we've all gone down the road. We've all seen these complicated devices that looks really odd as we're driving down the road when we see a substation, but they're actually pretty well designed. Electric substation have an utmost importance in electric distribution facility, converting AC voltages from one level to another level or change the nature of supply, meaning go from AC to DC. Now, AC to DC is very uncommon, right? But it is gaining popularity for the vast majority of electrical substation out there. It's converting from one voltage, AC voltage, to another AC voltage. Now, the general layout of a substation consists of conductors that run along the entire substation, and switches are really important, whether they're interrupting, fault interrupting switches or load interrupting switches. They play a very central role. Now, indoor substation, these substations are divided into different compartments for controlling and metering of devices. There's a lot of complexities when you design substation inside of a building. So not a lot of substations are designed that way, albeit some certainly are. Substations are further classified as pole-mounted substations, foundation-mounted substation, or surface-mounted substation. In terms of the required space, indoor substations are less, right? So you have to make everything compact, less space involved. But that also comes with a higher capital cost. As you have to shrink everything, you also have to pay extra for that square footage. Outdoor substation, much more required space because everything is spaced out, much easier to spot because everything is visible, right? In the layout of a substation, we have these, consider like the left part or part A and the right part, part B, which is a exact replica of each other. So we'll focus on the left part and you can see that it'll automatically get translated over to the right part. It's just a line that comes in, like a cable that comes in and goes and connects directly into the 12.47 kV bus. So it's connected to this bus right here, and this bus is nothing more than just a junction point, a node essentially, and that connects other components on that same node, right? Types of transformer depends on the location of the substation, as non-flammable, fluid insulated transformers and sealed transformers are suited for both indoor and outdoor use. So those are typically only outdoor. The size of the transformer in terms of KVA should be capable of holding sudden overload. 7 kV to 480 volt dry type transformer are in the range of 750 to 250 kVA. So for these 1240s, these voltages, these are very common for utility transformers that are serving 480 volt customers, right? Formula below is used to evaluate the cost of a transformer based on no load and full load losses. Basically, you know, the capital cost is equal to A times PO, and then you sum that with B, which is the per unit cost of the load losses, and you multiply that with PK, which is the losses due to the load. Switchgear refers to the integrated collection of devices to control and isolate electrical equipment through monitoring and protective equipment for power system protection. Switchgear is basically within, it allows you to take these voltages and distribute them in a very compact space. These transformers are used to step down high values of current into low current ranges, which small size relay can easily bear to operate effectively. Normally, the current on the secondary side of the CT that is going into the relay or the meter or other devices are either 5 amp rated or 1 amp rated, depending on the application. Now, circuit breakers have the following ratings. There's a continuous current rating of the circuit breaker, and it must be higher than the maximum continuous current draw by the load. That is very important, like the amount of current that continuously is drawn by the load. And asymmetrical is always higher than symmetrical fault currents. Asymmetrical is higher because it also considers the X over R ratio, and that is only in play for a very, very short period of time. High voltage fuses are generally applied for protecting power transformers. In a substation to provide inner updating of permanent fault should be selected according to the following standard rating. And so these are high voltage fuses for different types of applications. Now, and typically a disconnect switch is installed on both sides of a substation equipment. Like if you have a breaker, the switches are installed on the line side as well as the load side. And they're designed to carry load current continuously and momentarily carry short circuit currents for a defined duration without any overheating. So yeah, relays are automatic protective switchgear, mainly consists of relays and circuit breakers. So these are devices that protect the generator or transmission lines or motors or other heavy equipment like transformers and buses and that sort of thing. And the different types of relays are, you know, there's a differential relay, there's overcurrent relay, there's auto reclosing relay, there's ground relays, lots and lots of different types of relays. Surge arrestor is really important for areas, especially where there are lots of lightning. But typically, surge arrestors are very common in nearly all substation, outdoor substation applications. These are the voltages that are used. So under system voltage under 100 kV, its minimum rated voltage should be above 0.8 times UM. So the lack of protection of the equipment, which is not with the most protection or in close vicinity of the arrestors. Hello everyone, Abdur Rahman here from Alumiax Engineering. To learn more and to continue sharpening your technical skills, please subscribe to this YouTube channel, General Pack by Alumiax, or visit our website at alumiax.com/learn.